Yes, and slip you some Boogie Wee Willith. Ladies and gentlemen, for the Fringe FM, coming at you live from the middle of nowhere, the center of everywhere, here once again to give you yet another scrumptious dose of conversational boogie. This is Shift Happens. Yeah, sorry for the late start. We are using a brand new broadcasting system, which is awesome and excellent, and we've been working hard all week to get things right, and a couple of things didn't do the stuff, and we couldn't quite get everything dialed in. So our apologies for coming in late, but assuredly we will have everything back in order next week. Not sure if we'll be on the Fringe, so if you know any friends that are listening and they ask you, you know, where's the show, just tell them to go to shifthappensradio.com. That's where they can catch the show. But yeah, so apologies about all of that. But with all that away, joining us as per usual is our trusty co-host JP. What's happening, JP?
Well, here we go. You know, we put a lot of effort in, and I won't say it's for naught. Well, next week we'll be on Fringe. But
this just in, we are on the Fringe FM, according
hello.
To Jess. So
okay.
Yes. All right.
Well, there you go. So I was going to say we were cosmically cock-blocked, but I guess not. So that's good. Yes, we are ready to roll. It's going to be an interesting show. We'll probably, I guess maybe we can cut down our little normal intro. And I don't know. What do you feel about that? Maybe we should get started in a few.
Yeah, for sure. I just need to do a thing and a boop.
We are very excited about how things are going, though. I only wish Brad could join us. He's good to be around. But I think our our guest tonight will be really exciting. We'll talk about that in just a moment.
Absolutely, and also, just real quick reminder for everyone. GG. Okay, this comes from Elfman in the chat room. GG is good at blocking cocks. Just saying. Nothing gets past him. There you go. That's the kind of fanfare we get around here. At the old Shift Happens complex.
By the way, Elf, I have been experimenting with the crystals. They are fantastic. I definitely keep them by my desk, and I will at some point report more as soon as I can hopefully repeat the experiments. But it was very interesting.
Yeah, and okay, so some reports saying we're on the Fringe, some reports saying we're not. So I'm not sure. Thank you, Dragon Rose, for posting the Spreaker link. Either way, and nonetheless, if your friends missed the show and they want to catch it some other time, it's always available on our website, shifthappensradio.com. We got the whole episode archive right there in the middle of the homepage. You can stream it, you can download it, you can share it to all your friends, all that good fun stuff. And I'll have to check in a second here to see if we're actually on there, but yeah, there you go. And let's see, don't forget to get the Fringe FM app. It's the easiest way to listen to your shows, any of your shows, and throughout the day. We're playing, you know, while we were working today in the background, you know, I was just listening to, like, starting right early in the morning, just listening to, dude, we play a lot of cool music here on the Fringe FM. All types of genres, all types of categories. During, you know, okay, yes, we are on the Fringe FM. Good. But yeah.
Yeah, I just heard it too. Yeah, it's good. We're on.
And, fantastic. And, but yeah, man, all day long, there, if it's not a cool talk show, it's definitely cool music. And if it's not cool music, it's definitely a cool talk show that is on the Fringe FM 24 hours a day. And the best way to access that is really to get the Fringe FM app on your phone, available both on Android and iOS. Just look for the Fringe FM app, get it, and bam. And a lot of cool features on there. You can vote for your favorite show of the week and all kinds of cool stuff on there. And in fact, do vote for your favorite show of the week, and obviously vote for us. You know, that's the least. You
know what?
Do.
Another way is to vote for us, Gigi, is to buy us a coffee, and you can go to buy us. What is it? Buy me a coffee, right?
Yeah,
I always
yeah.
Click the link.
Yeah, if you want to help keep the show caffeinated and help give some funds towards our way in a nice, friendly, positive way, go to buymeacoffee.com/shifthappens.
And there we go.
Yeah, and a percentage of the proceeds actually go to a lot of environmental cleanup operations around the world in various forms. So not only are you helping, you know, the environment, you're helping the show, and you're helping keeping us caffeinated, and it's all good. So buymeacoffee.com/shifthappens, indeed, because we are no longer accepting donations from PayPal, because PayPal can blanket, and with all their... You would be surprised. There are new policies, my friends, and it's pretty crazy. And YouTube's been throwing a lot of our friends for a loop too lately as well, and which is another reason we, although we never promote YouTube, if you must, our replays are on YouTube. You can find us on YouTube, but if you really want to support the show, don't listen on YouTube, because that doesn't help us at all. Go to Spotify, go to the Fringe FM, the Fringe FM app, the replays on the Fringe FM app, go to shifthappensradio.com, go to Spreaker. Any other way is better than that. But, you know, if you've got your grandma, you know, you want to share her the show, she only knows YouTube, you know, go ahead. Share the YouTube link. But other than that, try not to, you know, we're not trying to promote YouTube here. So we just have it there as a backup, just in case anything happens. So there you go. And my cat has successfully chewed through my headphone wire. Fantastic.
Congratulations. Yes.
Yes. Congratulations, kitty. Thanks, buddy. And all right. So with all that, let's go ahead and good question. Oh, Queen Babylon. Hey, what's happening, Queen?
In
good
queen.
To see ya. Long time no see. Well, we saw you a little bit ago. Good to see you again. And Fletch asks, who's the guest tonight? And I'll let you take it away from here, JP.
You know what? This is a really amazing cosmic connection. And I'm really glad that we have an amazing guest tonight. Where the topic goes, I mean, it really, I'm going to fish around. I'm going to get a feel for what the Nameless One is feeling and see if we could start from there. But when I get into conversations about this system, this kind of like this extra layer, I don't know, it's a divergence from what is real in my life. When I think about all of the buckets of shift that I've stepped in, it's pretty sad. I think we've all done it. We've all been programmed in some way or another. Well, there's some nice exceptions out there, obviously, but I think fighting through the programming and also recognizing that we do live in a system that is designed to make us forget things, it's an amazing thing to find somebody who's really just dedicating much. I don't know to what degree, but we're going to find out of his life is actually really like devoted to this. And I'm really excited because we've been chatting a while, and I read a lot of his writings, and he's full of amazing tips and amazing observations. And so, yeah, I'm really proud to introduce the Nameless One. Are you there, sir?
Yes, appreciate it, fellas. How was everyone tonight?
Excellent.
Fantastic. So very much looking forward to having this conversation, although I do have to say we are going to have to take a break in about 2.5 minutes. So, due to our late start, which again is our fault, so apologies, folks. But good to meet you, sir. And JP's spoken highly of you, and can't wait to see what we're gonna get into tonight.
So, yeah, any background you'd like to talk about for a couple minutes?
Well, I think I've been studying this stuff since I was a young boy, because I knew something was just not right, and I was brought around a lot of people. I was brought up middle class, but there was people that worked at the Vatican and people in the court system. So that's a lot of the reasons why I can connect the dots, because I can remember certain things that were said that I may not have been able to connect the dots when I was younger. However, now it's like crystal clear. And so that definitely helps, but not everybody has that type of background, so it may be more difficult when you're bringing, you know, information's coming forth and you're like trying to discern it. So I try to discern it and then basically, you know, give it out to people and see where it goes.
You're amazing. You're amazingly generous with your thoughts and how you've interpreted it all. So, yeah, we'll get into that for sure. And I think, Gigi, how are we doing there? We're just about ready to... Or does it do it automatically? I don't even know.
Well, it would if the thing did the stuff, but the thing didn't do the stuff, and we're not attached to the stuff, so... Okay. We're running... we're switching to manual, as one does in a spacecraft at a last minute Mars landing, right? I don't know. I just got done watching the whole series of For All Mankind. Oh my goodness! If you guys haven't seen that show, really cool show. Got a couple seconds left. It's a show. The preface is that the Russians landed on the moon first, and then the show takes off from there, and then it goes all the way up into the future, into Mars landings and stuff, and how they predict that it would have played out if that were the case. Very interesting show. Highly recommended. It's only on Apple TV for some reason. Great show, though. But with that, yes, we will pick up where we left off here. We do have to cut to our first commercial break. Ladies and gentlemen, you are listening to Shift Happens here for the Fringe FM. I'm your host, Gigi, along with our co-host, JP.
Yeah, we're live!
We are live, and we're here tonight with The Nameless One. We'll be back here in just a few short commercially minutes. Don't go anywhere.
Pure Health Defenders, proud sponsor of Shift Happens, producing organic and natural health.
All right, so my iPod just decided to take a shift and die, so we'll have to pull that back up. In the meantime, I will be doing a bunch of blah, blah, blah until this thing reboots up. Okay. Here we go. Follow along with me, folks. Let's, oh, wow. Yeah, this is, interesting. Okay. Well, you know, this is quite beyond me. Yeah, I don't know. I guess we'll, here we go. Okay, back to the stuff that does all the things that we need it to do. And back we go.
Tired of talking about the weather? No shit.
Okay, well, that's just kind of weird. Oh boy. Well, this isn't very good, is it? Nope, no good indeed. Oh, there it was. Alright, we will skip forward. I don't know what's going on. I've been doing this 6 years, never had this problem in particular. So, yeah, I'm not sure what to do here. Let's go play that.
Tired of talking about the weather. No.
Alright, well, that's not working. So, you know what? No commercial breaks. We're just going to get right back to the show. So, you guys ready?
Yeah.
Yes, I'm.
All right, take it away, JP.
Okay, all right. So, well, thank you, you know, taking us back a little bit there. And I suppose, unless you had more to add to the background stuff, where are you at today? And what are some things on your mind? Where do you want to start?
Well, basically, it started what I always, when my sister got married, I remember my mother saying that she should go see the priest to see if it was okay for her to get married. And I was like, what does the priest know that I don't know? So I said this mentally. So I've basically was seeking for that information, you know, and I met this lady at the coffee shop, and she saw me with these tacky on purple wrist brands that I wear, and she's like, okay, those are either bicycle reflectors or that man knows a lot of stuff. So she came up to me and started talking to me, and she goes, okay, he's you know, a spiritual being, quote unquote. And she told me she had been studying the playing card science, which the science of the cards based upon the day your biology emerged out of the birth canal is a very, very deep science. And that's what the priests know. That's why everybody goes to the priest when they have problems, because the priest understands the card programmings that our biology is under. Now, I know there's a lot of people that, you know, say, oh, the birthday, oh, I don't have a birthday and all this other stuff. No, you need to know the programming of that day you emerged out of the birth canal. because there's things that happen. We're all under it. We are all under that programming. And there are certain things that happen. Like if you have a nine of spades in Mercury, you have to be very careful when you're on the roads, when you're on short trips. Like I'll tell people when they have a nine of spades in Mercury, I'd be like, be careful on the roads. And then sometimes I didn't tell them that, and they got in a car accident on the day they had the nine of spades in Mercury. But if you become aware of the programmings, you can basically control them. You can kind of stop things from happening. Like if you want to go out with a woman, you're not going to want to go out on a day when your energies don't merge very well. Like if she has a two of hearts in Venus, that's a day you want to experience her because she's going to be very blissful and want to exchange divine feminine energy with you. So it's a deep science, and it's, you know, a lot of people don't understand it and they come to you. So when I found that information out, it was very significant. And then when I came across Kurt Kallenbach's information about fertilization being the origin of life, and I went deeper into that information because I used to write a book with Kurt's information in it. So I'm about editing the truth. I'm constantly editing what people think is true. So a lot of people have called hospitals and been hung up on and asked questions and things like that. Well, and that had happened to me. However,
the hospital I was born in is no longer exists. That's the problem I ran into. But go on.
But what's interesting about this, and what people don't know, I had a lot of people come to me with child protective services issues. And I'd always be like, how does child protective services even get involved with this? Well, what I found out was just, it just blew my mind. Because when the woman enters the foundling hospital, which some of your people probably know what a foundling is, where you abandon property. She enters it voluntarily carrying a package, you know, the baby, in her delivery truck. So essentially, she enters voluntarily, and what happens, the hospital makes a presumption that she's abandoning property. So what happens is Child Protective Services goes into effect, does court filings, takes custody of that property, and allows the mother to have quote-unquote medical consent. But they do court filings, and then the hospital gets paid Medi-Cal. Child Protective Services files for Medi-Cal, and that's how the hospital gets paid for safe surrenders. So then what I decided to do, I called a foster agency. Because I realized I was looking at it from a safe surrender being like you abandoned the baby at the door of the hospital type of thing. But then when I called the foster care agency, I said, if the woman enters the hospital voluntarily, basically all these births are safe surrender. And she went, bingo. So that's how Child Protective Services got involved, because of the voluntary entrance that the woman made to the hospital. And then what I found out, I called the fire station, because the fire station's also a foundling institution. So I said, the birth certificate, right, has place of birth, and these foundling institutions are tax exempt. So you never see the place of birth on any of these credentials, do you? Because the place of birth would basically say you're tax exempt.
Mine was redacted. That whole column, that section is redacted. It's bizarre.
What on my the place of birth?
On the certificate of live birth, it's just blacked out. But I suppose there's a way of getting it unredacted. I believe it's a code that they put in there for, I think, and I'm talking about the city maybe of maybe not the exact, it's not the exact location, it's just the city that was for whatever reason redacted.
But basically every certificate of live birth is, they already know it's a foundling institution. I mean, if there's one on record, but that's just one way to handle it. But I understood why they don't have place of birth on any of these credentials, because then if they saw the credentials, they knew they could not charge you, because tax and charge are synonymous. So when they try to charge you, they're trying to tax you. So I asked an FBI agent one time, I said, the synonym game that they're playing is significant, is it not? And the FBI agent said, yes, it's very significant. So that's how they confuse us with all these different synonyms. So I've had conversations with people at the hospital, and I've called multiple hospitals, and one hospital called it one thing, and then I'm arguing with the other hospital, and I end up realizing we're talking about the same thing. So keep a synonym dictionary close to you when you're dealing with any of this stuff.
And so many dangerous words have really taken place because of the way that system is derived, like the whole concept of equity comes from this, and from going back to kind of with Kurt's work, he would say that the cut umbilical cord creates a born alive foundling, or aka an orphan. So the wordplay here is just insane. It goes all over the place. Very confusing, I think, for a lot of people to see through.
Well, what I found with the placenta, because I thought it was about, I thought the birth certificate was based upon the quote unquote placenta, but I realized from talking with different personnel at the hospitals and talking about the protocols that take place that it's not. Because born alive has to have lungs, and the placenta, according to the people that deal with the placenta, has no lungs. And so if you go to the mortuary, which I did, and I said, I need a burial permit for the placenta, because I thought, I was testing Kurt's research out, and they said, you don't need a burial permit for the placenta. And then I was like, because I was going to use the burial permit to basically say, hey, these charges involve a dead, a placenta. So these corporations couldn't charge, because it was like almost the burial permit was like a death certificate. So then I realized, okay, it's not about the placenta. It's a record of us coming out on that day that's part of the calendar. So then I went and I called the coroner and I said, hey, I need a death certificate in regards to the placenta. And they were like saying, what are you talking about? They're like, no, that's not what it's about. It's a record of when you emerged out of the birth canal. Not even though the placenta came out that day, if it was solely based upon the placenta, then you'd be able to get a death certificate, but you're not getting a death certificate based upon it. So it causes a lot of confusion and things like that. So if people think it's about the placenta, and it's not. It's just, I haven't found any evidence from those calls, and I made hundreds of them that basically stated that it's not about that. Because if it was, I tried to get a death certificate. I tried to get a burial permit.
Sure. In practice, a lot of this stuff is very difficult to prove in any way. So what did you find to be more helpful?
Well, I found an interesting thing that there's so many different ways to handle this. There's no such thing as a purchaser's tax. So when any purchase that is made with a credit card, you can basically null and void it. There's no such thing as a purchaser's tax. There's only seller's tax. So you can handle it that way. They have the collection plates at church. So one time I was I stopped at a food truck that was in the parking lot of a church. and the man was the deacon of the church. So I started talking to him about all this stuff. And I said, what you should do is put your tax bills in the collection plate, because that's what it is. It's a tax collection plate. So they're to forgive the debt, right? So people are putting these Federal Reserve notes in the collections plates that they go to church on Sunday, and they should put the bills in there. And all of a sudden, he told me something that was really interesting. He says, we are never to deny someone that comes to us with a financial hardship, and it didn't matter the amount. There was no, you know, it didn't, no limit. And this was a small church. So they know this. So if people just would drop off their bills to these churches and say, and what I was going to do, the churches, when I was growing up, they used to have the doors open. So I was going to go bring the bills up when the church was open and put them on the altar with a note saying, please make sure you send these bills to God so he can discharge them. And this is how ridiculous it is. It's a joke, and we're making this stuff real. And they're just playing us left and right.
The writings that you had submitted and posted were caught my eye. And, you know, it's something I'm still, I'm looking to test out as well. Yeah, it's an amazing thing.
Even the belly button knowledge, people, like, I have people that like travel a lot and they don't like to be, with the TSA agents. So I'm like, your belly button is biological evidence that you are foreign to the legal jurisdiction that they're claiming you're part of. So all you have to do is lift up your shirt and show your belly button, and that's it.
International law agrees with you, by the way.
Oh, is that right? What'd they say about the belly button?
It just fits in together when it's all kind of broken down. And, you know, there's nothing that I saw specifically that says what you're saying, but when you test it all out, there's a lot of it's almost like a zipper that comes together with just kind of how we're looking at it this way, and with all the research and words that I've found here, and I've, you know, in an international law basis, it just fits together, and it's up to, you know, me to go in and figure out how to apply it to my situation.
Because the belly button is basically evidence that you're non-legal. So you can never be held for any legal charge whatsoever. They used to have IRS offices in every town, but they've closed a lot of them. So
yep.
A very wise man, Andrew from Australia, he was one that went to the IRS office and told somebody at the office that the birth certificate was proof of a constructive trust, and they paid all the water bills, all his tax bills, everything. So you could basically do the same thing with your belly button if the IRS offices were still in effect, and tell them to issue a direct express card from Social Security Administration, unlimited, and then go about your business of whatever you desire to have happen. You shouldn't be all of this is a bunch of nonsense there. And then I realized I was talking to a homeless guy, and he was telling me a story how the cop asked him to search his backpack, and he said that he had medicine in it or something like that. And the cop said to the other cop, oh, he said medicine, we got to leave. And I was like, do you know what you just said? I go, the reason the cop left is because he knew that he's impersonating a doctor. They're impersonating doctors. All of these traffic stops are these people impersonating doctors. That's prestige fraud. Everybody reports them to the, you know, they make a complaint with the police department. No, you got to contact the medical board. If we're impersonating a police officer, they'll throw us in prison. And these people want to do you know, drug test to see if you're drunk? Do they have medical license? TSA agents want to do examinations of your biology? They have no medical license to do that, and we're accepting it. It's insane. And they're all, every traffic stop, and I don't say that you should be driving drunk and all this stuff, but it's sickening that we're hindered by these people that are just playing these, impersonating all these different roles. And the main one is basically they're impersonating a doctor, and we're allowing it to happen. And they do not want to get reported to the medical board. I will tell you that for a fact. They have no desire to have a report done with the medical board for impersonating a doctor. And they do know that that's what they're doing.
Now, I have heard if you are detained on an international flight, you can tell them that you have a belly button, and they have to acknowledge this. I don't know if really? You've heard anything to this, but yeah, that's it. It really is an important thing, and it's, you know, again, you don't want to test this stuff out unless you understand, you know, what it all entails. I would imagine. I mean, I think a lot of people are just scared to ruffle feathers. For example, they don't want to like contact the IRS and write a letter that they're not sure will, you know. I also, I guess, intent is such a heavy player in all of this as well.
You have the congressman do it, because Congress represents the pineal, which is Congress makes law in the body, which is the pineal. The hypothalamus is the executive branch that executes law in the body, and the pituitary is the judicial branch that interprets law within the body. So the congressman, a lady that was very well versed in San Francisco politics when I was young, she used to say, always contact your congressman, contact your congressman for anything you desire. And she always like said it to me. And she's, every time I saw her, she'd say the same thing. And I'd be like, what is she talking about? Because back then I just thought, you know, you contact the congressman to get tickets to the White House to, you know, view the White House. But it goes deeper. They communicate with the Social Security Administration. They communicate with the Postmaster General. We have to realize that every payment that is made is an act of war. So these people are demanding payments. And even Verizon told me, I go, they tell you, do you accept the charges? But they don't tell you if it's positive or negative charges. And they're all positive charges. The charges are not being negated.
Completely backwards.
That's why the creator is into negation. Not about creation. It's about negation. And once you understand this, now you can start, you know, really making progress, because they have to negate everything. I mean, it's all over. The Lord's Prayer says all debts are to be forgiven. You can do it with the belly button. You could go to the church and have what should have been done when you came out of the womb. And this, the hospital will tell you this, is that the reason they cut the umbilical cord is because they do not desire the baby to become septic, because when you come out of the womb, you go into a state of decomposition. So whether you agree with it or not, actually, and what should happen, in my view, is what a lady told me the ancients did. Silver purifies. So you put the baby and the amniotic fluid in a silver bowl, and then you have the baby and the amniotic fluid in the silver bowl, and it's purified, and then you let the umbilical cord come off when it does. And that's how it should be done. But that's the protocol the hospital is using. You can't tell them they broke the package or medical incompetence. because that you entered voluntarily. The only emergency exists is us emerging out of the birth canal. Everything else is a crisis. So they're going to take emergency measures, and one of those is to cut the umbilical cord. Whether you agree with it or not, that's the protocol that's in place, and that's what they do. And I'm not going to blame them for it. I may not agree with it, but it happened. And so you move forward and you get beyond it and you understand how to now counteract it and basically go about the business of correcting some of those mistakes.
That is amazing. Hey, by the way, Gigi, where are we at as far as breaks? What are we doing on that?
I think we are going to be able to take the next breaks. So we've got about 2 minutes left. Yeah.
How about, okay. So this is amazing information, the nameless one. How would you kind of wrap up this before we move on to maybe something different after
just
the break?
When you come out, anybody that's having a baby, when they come out, have a priest there and give them what is known as last rites, but it's the sacrament of healing. So you basically, they anoint you with olive oil. And so that olive oil is the highest form of melanin, which some people call 666 or the carbon. So I would have that done, because you go into a state of decomposition when you emerge out of the birth canal. But the sacrament of healing can be done at any time. And you could go to the church, have an anointment done, and then bring those bills to the church and tell them to anoint the bills and give them to the sexton of the church so the bills can have a proper burial, because a sexton of a church is the one who deals with burials, proper burials, because those bills need to be buried.
For sure. For sure. All right. Any questions happening, Gigi, that you can tell, or how we doing in the chat room?
Lots of questions in the chat room. And
this is live, Mr. Tuskin.
Yes, we are live. Yes, Bob. This is, as always, I'm not sure what makes you ever think we're not live, but we're live every single time. So, yes, we are live. Thanks for tuning in, Bob. Just noticed a little disconnect between some folks in the audience wondering.
Oh, it's controversial, dude. It's just controversial all the way.
Not even that. Some people are just wondering what. Well, I can't really speak for them. I'd have to go back in the comments, and I'm not going to do that. But
well, one question is, what if there is no church around? I think you were saying any church, you could bring this. It's not just...
You could go to a fire station. You can go to a police station. They're all foundling institutions. They're to basically handle the foundling child, and the birth certificate's a record of the foundling child. That's the quote-unquote evidence that the state is responsible for the foundling child. So go to the whole planet's a foundling institution. We're all abandoned here. We came from somewhere else, and we're trying to find our way back.
Most of the arguments will come from people who don't know what the words mean. So I'll just scroll right past some of those. All right, it's time, Gigi. By the way, it's time.
Yeah, it is time. And we're going to take our next, well, technically our first commercial, our first successful commercial break.
That's right.
Shall be happening
now.
Right this very now. Ladies and gentlemen, you're listening to Shift Happens Here. On The Fringe FM, I'm your host, Gigi Lothar, co-host JP.
Aye.
And we're here tonight with the Nameless One, talking about all kinds of stuff that we're talking about. And we'll be back here in just a few short, commercially minutes. Don't go anywhere.
Yohoi there. It's Gigi from Shift Happens, and you're shaking some conversational tail feather to the Fringe FM.
Thousands of people are having paranormal experiences with ghosts, demons, shadow people, dogmen, Bigfoot, and more. Their stories need to be told, and they are being told. Dark Waters, the renowned storyteller, invites you to join at IamDarkWaters.com. For just a few dollars a month, you can listen to some of the most hair-raising and compelling stories on the planet. You'll have access to real-life stories told by Dark Waters. Thousands of hours of content. Their encounters are being told and told by the best at IamDarkWaters.com. Listen to stories like The Rabbit Man, The Dogman Encounter in Silas, Alabama, The Man with No Face, The Other Woman, A Day Ahead of the Devil, Dogman Murder in Hurricane Ida, even a story of someone trying to kill a dogman, Louisiana Water Demon Stories. Sign up today and become a member at IamDarkWaters.com. That's IamDarkWaters.com.
Hey there, this is Jess, host of the Jess Rogie Show, and you're listening to KTLK Digital Broadcasting Fringe FM.
Musicians experience a lot of frustration with music marketing and promotion. They have no idea how to get their music heard, and they're spending hours sending emails, making phone calls, and hitting up their friends to promote them. With our industry-powered digital marketing platform, we can set up your media plan in minutes. Our team will automatically distribute your music across all the best channels, so you can focus on actually making the music. Submit your music today on our website at mymusicpromoter.com. That's mymusicpromoter.com.
Have you suffered in silence or experienced stress from a paranormal experience? Even if it happened 20 years ago, when thinking or talking about it today still makes you feel sick to your stomach or makes your heart beat faster, or you suddenly can't breathe. Maybe you even feel those old familiar signs of a panic attack trying to reach the surface. You could have unprocessed emotional responses. Those reactions of terror and trauma are no different than living through a horrible assault, childhood abuse, or a terrible car accident. It can be nearly impossible to find help. The very instance of seeing a ghost or encountering a cryptid could be clinically described as seeing or hearing things that aren't there. You could be considered psychotic, or at best, you're just not taken seriously. Out of a growing mountain of research, the National Institute for Integrative Healthcare showed that 8 out of 10 veterans who completed just 6 one-hour EFT sessions no longer tested positive for PTSD. If you've had paranormal trauma, you can contact Metaphorical Archaeology by calling 214-995-3754. Again, that's 214-995-3754 for a discreet consultation.
KTLK Digital Broadcast. We rock the paranormal talk.
Gentlemen, for the Fringe FM. This is Shift Happens. I'm your host, Gigi, along with our co-host, JP.
Yes, sir. I got something nice to read. You ready?
All right, let's go for it.
Okay. Now, this is something that D Nameless One wrote, and I found particularly interesting. Christ consciousness is the dawning or realization of non-duality, embracing complete unity of intelligence with feeling. Realization, the unification of life, affirming living waters, thought, deeds, infused with the wisdom of dynamic conscious change. Realization of Christ consciousness or the kingdom of heaven happens inwardly by the complete renewing of our minds, quote from Romans 12.2, so that we can authentically say we have the mind of Christ. Christ consciousness is not elimination of sin, evil, egotism, or other illusions of neurotic separateness, however, transformation of it through incorporating and transcending it through the very understanding of its nature and reversing its narrowing of reality with respect to the relative manifestation. Wow, this is incredible, but can you encapsulate it? And I don't feel Christ consciousness is religious. I feel that it's something that we have the ability to adopt over animal instinct and the such. But what are you saying here, if you don't mind me asking?
Well, one, it was interesting because when one was in jail, you know, you're having these psych evaluations when you're attempting to fight this thing the way many of us have done. And the one thing, I wouldn't talk about the case. And the therapist said, "Are you the Christ?" And I said, "The whole story of the Christ is a function that happens in the body every time you take a breath." And he said, "You don't belong here." And he goes, "You're right. There is no contract to hold you here." So I thought I was getting out the next day. I was like going, "Oh, this is phenomenal," because they're basing these psych evaluations to send you to mental hospitals and all these different things. So what happened was the public defender the next day stood 10 feet away from me and starts saying that there was something wrong with the medical evaluation. And I was like objecting to it, and they were setting me up to basically try to make me look crazy because they knew I was intelligent enough to know of what the Christ consciousness was. And if that spread throughout the jail, everybody else was gonna, or lots of people were gonna use it. And so, you know, understanding just that simple point is basically, because they'll ask you, you know, in jail, they'd be like, "Are you the Christ?" And I've heard that, not only I had the personal experience of it, but other people have had that same experience where they've asked that question. So if you understand Christ consciousness and understand that every breath, you know, is the Christ consciousness, then, you know, things will start coming to you, and ideas and people and just amazing things happen. Once you understand it, it's just basically moving to the right hemisphere of the brain, you know, taking your thought forms and, you know, going to that area of the, you know, and the Christ has been around. They left, it used to be Chrysomelos, Melos meaning black, so it was the black Christ, but they took that word out of the dictionary. They didn't want people to understand that aspect of it.
With the information that you're discussing and what you know overall, are you really surprised at where we are based on how others view our language and how they use words and how they comprehend words, like, say, off of a television?
Well, there's so many different. I mean, they're using colors. They're using sound frequencies. I mean, there's so many things that shut these people down, and they're not a simple thing that I tell people. the technology uses something that called graphic user interface technology. It's called GUI. Most people know it as GUI. And that's code name for ghost. Well, the medical definition of ghost is something that eats up disorderly energy in your hemoglobin, which is talking about the sunlight. So, but these artificial light codes are eating up what's divine in your hemoglobin. So when I talk to somebody and they'll be like, wow, this is unbelievable. It could be if they get on their cell phone 10 minutes later, it'd be like I didn't talk to them because of these light codes that are coming out of the phone. And they're touching it with their fingers. They're looking through the screens. Those codes are coming through your eyes and the ears. And so I wear lead protective glasses. I wear an EMF hoodie. You know, I wear a mirror. You have to reflect those energies back. Like and Faraday, I wear a mirror all the time.
Are you using Faraday cages or anything like this?
Oh, the Faraday cages. That's one of the things that I hope to implement. If we were all sleeping in Faraday cages, there would be a major difference in people's thought patterns. No doubt. Because they come, even the springs of the bed, they send transmissions into you through those springs. They're entrainment devices. So they're even messing with you when you're on a bed, and then you're having sex and trying to have orgasms, and they're sending signals to mess up your orgasms. It's insane, some of all the different things that they're using to keep us at a level of understanding that's just not going to be able to get us out of this light code lockdown. And the understanding of photons will also help people, because what they're doing is zapping the electrons from the environment. And the photons within us is like the God within us. So photons are attracted to electrons. So if your electrons are being zapped from your environment, technology, or whatever it may be, the photons within you are going to go dormant. And so the power, the God power, quote unquote, within you is going to be on lockdown. So it needs that the electrons to basically stimulate. And that's what causes problems in relationships also. So it's not only causing it within your body, it causes it within, husband, wife, children, you know, all kinds of things. So these people know what they're doing, I can tell you that.
What about, I was trying to, you know, look at some of these other, there's just so many places to go with it, but I'm just curious, what do you feel about dreams and that whole experience and lucid dreaming for that matter?
That's my favorite time, is to basically close my eyes, is to go to that realm where you receive the subconscious mind or whatever you want to call it, and to go to the darkness. But the issue is sometimes the little man that dwells within you, the real you, will look for a speck of light. And it'll go out and play with the distorted light. So this is why people are not cleansed, because you have to sleep in complete darkness, because even if there's a speck of light there, it will go play with it. So you're not really getting cleansed to the level that you could be if you were sleeping in complete darkness. You should, if you can, shut off the electricity from outside. It's a whole different sleep experience. If you don't have a Faraday cage, try to shut off the electricity, because it messes with the pineal spin, all that alternating current. And like women would sleep over my house and I'd shut off the electricity, and they'd be like, wow, I could sleep really well at your house. And it was because the electricity did not disturb them. Because women are very frequency based. So a lot of the experimentation that I do
it's fun to have the women over because they really make me understand that I'm on the right path in regards to something I may be studying. They'd be like, oh, this definitely works.
For sure. Absolutely.
Because they're orgasmic beings. So if they can have an orgasm every 8/10 of a second and sustain it for 3 to 4 hours straight.
Hello.
And have enough energy to move the furniture all over the house. That's how much power they have. And I told this young woman, I go, do you know how much power you have? You could have one sperm put you in a dark room for 9 months, and basically you have the ability to magnetize everything that you need to bring in a physical human being into existence. That takes a human being has a lot of moving parts, and that's the power they have. And she says to me, like, she's like, well, that sounds like torture. And I'm like, did you hear what I said? I'm talking about the type of power you have. And right. She's looking at it like it's torture.
Like a work, like a job.
Yeah, well, they're working 2-3 jobs. And when you look at they're having women chase these careers, and career means combat. So they're constantly in a state of war. And so their orgasmic nature, which brings bliss to the planet, is not able to manifest to the level that it should be. And it's disturbing to not only them, but to the men that are with them. And so we're here to bring clarity to the woman. And because when you open an acupuncturist told me this one time, he said, when you open a woman's feminine side, he says, a lot of the times you'll never see her again because she's comfortable in masculine energy. But when you open her up on the feminine energy, she's not used to that. And she gets kind of freaked out, and she's like, you know, and I've seen it happen myself. I've had women and they've went in this orgasmic state and their face cleared up and they're just like euphoric, and then they leave and I never see them again. And I'm like going, and they be, and some have told me, they go, I don't know how to handle someone that's able to do what you're able to do with me.
Setting them free.
Yeah. And it's not complicated. One girl was all dressed in nice clothing, and I touched her hand and I put my finger in her medulla oblongata.
Yes.
And it was very simple, nothing. And she started bawling, crying, just like tears flowing. And she's like, didn't know how to handle it. And that stuff's got to come out. And these 23-year-old women, you hug them and you could feel their pain. They're 23 years old. And they're literally, I'm like, let it out. And they're like crying and moaning and sounds. I'm telling you, I've heard some sounds of the devil come out of these women. I mean, you talk about wanting to be in the dark side. Woo! Some of the sounds that come out. I know where these horror movies get these sounds. You traumatize a woman, and she'll let them out. And she can also let out some sounds of bliss, because if she's on lockdown and we suppress her and she can't hear her own sounds, she doesn't even know she exists. And then the man doesn't know where to find her if he doesn't hear her sounds of bliss. And so he's hunting for her in the dark, and he has nowhere to go. And guess what happens? Dysfunction will start coming to the surface in all areas of life. But when a woman is blissful, it brings that's what a man loves to see. He loves to see the woman experiencing bliss. but she wants to do 9 to 5 and do all this other stuff, and it basically depresses him because he has nothing to be attracted to.
I've heard you talk about an inversion board, and I know you've sent me information, but I'm wondering if you can explain, because it's our ability to meditate, be calm, and strengthen ourselves in ways that a job doesn't allow us to, and running around and living life doesn't always allow us to. How is an inversion board incorporated into, say, like just a normal routine? And, what does it do?
Well, the inversion table being hung upside down is very, very relaxing. And so I had this inversion table, and my friend told me it's like people that have prostate problems, it's like 3 months, for a prostate doctor. And that's for the uterus also, because the same problems that happen to the prostate will happen to the uterus. And so I know infrared light heals the genitals. So what I did was I took the inversion board, and where your feet go, I put an infrared light there. So when you're on the inversion board, the infrared light shining directly into your genital areas, no matter what angle the inversion board is at. And then I took I have like a photon negative ion emitting mat that I lay on the board, so you're laying on that. And then on the opposite side, I have a facial steamer, so you're getting like a facial steamer. And so it's extremely relaxing. I'm the only one that tried it so far, because I only thought about it, I created it like couple of days ago, but there's some people that'd be like, hey, can I come over and try that? And so I'm big into light and creating different modalities to use to enhance the light, along with these different trampolines and inversion tables. And a man was on my trampoline device that I have infrared light shining at his genitals. And he had prostate problems, and he hadn't had an erection for many months. And 2 days after he did this, he had an erection. And the woman that had tested it out, she had her uterus removed, and she felt her uterus regenerating during the experience. So it's very powerful, but it's very difficult to even I offered to do these things free, but people are stuck. And I've seen, I don't know if you guys are seeing it, but a lot of women especially have noticed. One lady is now, she's like stuttering, and she didn't have a stuttering problem, and now all of a sudden she's stuttering. She doesn't know why. Another mm-hmm. one has issues with migraines. And she goes, oh, I tried everything. I go, no, you have not tried everything.
I've seen breakdowns of the proprioceptive, motor ability, like just not knowing their place in relation to space and time. Like they're dizzy. They're falling over. It's unbelievable. I've seen this quite a few times.
Is it recent? Like yes. Really recent?
Yes. Recent. Yeah. Like this week.
Really? Yeah. Same thing with me. So I told her I have like going from hot to cold supercharges the cells. It increases the cell voltage. So what I did was I got an infrared hair dryer. So it has a cool button. So I blow it. One of my friends had oral surgery, and I blew the infrared light into his mouth, and then I hit the cool button, and I did it on and off. And the dentist gave him a bunch of drugs, and he goes, I had more healing from that than I did all the things that the dentist gave him for the pain. So going from hot to cold is very, very significant. So you can use just an infrared light hair dryer and doing that and putting the fish bubblers, like you get a fish bubbler that goes in the fish tank that allows more oxygen to enter into the fish. Well, what I do is I put it in my mouth because I look at the body as an aquarium and the cells as fish. And I had a Rastafarian brother that used to come over the house all the time. And he'd be like, "Papa, that's a great idea." And I'd be like, "It is," because saliva and salvation are synonymous. So clean out that saliva. So that's another way you can do it. And one girl, actually, she goes, "Can you put that fish bubbler in my vagina?" Because she had issues down there. So I put it between two bamboo spoons and placed it in her vagina. And she was shocked at what was going on inside of her for the small amount of time she had it in her.
Was it a good experience for her?
Yeah, she felt a cleansing, a purification happening when it was in there. And I would implement acacia honey. Like if you're intimate, acacia honey, acacia is very high in monoatomic gold. It's euphoric to the body. I mean, euphoric. I had the woman on the trampoline and I was feeding her strawberries with acacia honey on it. And it was one of the most magical things I was watching, just this woman eating strawberries with acacia honey. I was actually getting jealous feeding her these strawberries with the honey. So I started feeding them to myself.
Wow. I'm blushing. That's amazing.
You should be. Just imagine if you were tasting it. Oh, it was, that was an experience. Holy mackerel.
I think we're about ready here to get into another break, I think, right, Gigi? Got another minute or so. Oh, am I mute?
Yeah, no, we got about a minute here.
We have some curious people in the chat room tonight. It's wild. We're getting a lot of great comments. I'm so glad to see everybody here. The Fringe FM. Man, Lily is here. The Rocker. Didn't say his name. Nice. This is amazing information. I'm really glad to be talking with you here about that. But I think we're about ready for that break.
Yeah, so here's what's going to happen is if you're listening on The Fringe, you're going to hear some good old-fashioned commercial break. If you're listening on shifthappensradio.com, you're just going to hear some music. But rest assured, whichever one you hear, I just want you to know that you're still at the right place. Nothing's going wrong. Right. Yeah, so
don't change that dial.
Don't change that dial. And ladies and gentlemen, I'm your host, Gigi Law, with our co-host JP, rocking the chair tonight with our guest, the Nameless One. And we'll be back here after a few short commercially / musical minutes. Don't go anywhere. us, ladies and gentlemen, for the French FM. This is Shift Happens. I'm your host, Gigi Lothar, co-host JP.
All right. Yeah, we're back.
And we're here tonight with our guest, the Nameless One. And lots of questions from the chat room. Lots of people confused. Lots of people lost. Some people are there. Some people are really there. We've got the whole spectrum. So we'll turn it right back to you, JP.
All right. Well, let's see if there's any questions here that might be good to ask. I'm not sure if there's anything. Nothing stands out yet for me. I don't know. So, the Nameless One. Was there anything, that you're itching to get at? And tell us also, is there a way people can find you, or you, do you prefer to stay in a somewhat anonymous?
They can contact me either a text at 530-717-7692 if they desire to know anything about their card programmings or the programmings that involve their cards, whether it themselves or maybe they're having an issue with a child and they want to know what the child's going through. You know, an example is there was this woman at the deli, and she just had a baby, and she told me what day it emerged out of the birth canal. And I told her that when that child is age 6 years old, she's going to be your worst nightmare. And so she kind of looked at me kind of like freaked out. And 6 years later, she said, she came up to me and she's like, "Hey, do you remember you told me my child was going to be my worst nightmare when she was six? She's 6 years old right now, and she's my worst nightmare." She goes, "How did you know this?" And I go, "Well, the cards don't lie, because there's certain programming. It's like, you know, if you came here on December 9th, right, at age seven, you might have a real challenging year, you know. Just because you're seven doesn't mean it's going to be a year filled with bliss. Everybody goes through these cycles. And so they come back around, and I've had people that have been in nightmare cycles, and literally they were talking to their friends at my house, and they said, they didn't realize I was nearby, and they said, if it wasn't for him, I would have committed suicide. So there's a lot of people that are suicidal just based upon not knowing their programming. And I've had experiences where I've sat down at a couch, and the woman was on the couch, and she kind of moved, and I thought she didn't want me to sit there. And then she's like, "No, you can sit there." And I had my cardboards with me. I have these boards that I made, and she's like, "What's that?" And so I showed her her situation, and she was on the verge of committing suicide that day. When she was sitting down at the cafe, she was going to commit suicide on that day. And she goes, "I brought so much clarity to her that she didn't do it." And that wasn't the only situation. So people, whether it's me or somebody else, if you're in a situation, find somebody who understands the cards and get some feedback from them. So I have a lot of people when they're in a dramatic situation, they contact me, and then when they go through the good cycle, I don't hear from them. It's like, right, they only come when they're under trauma.
You know, that's a very real situation, I think, right now, though. I haven't seen the numbers, but I get the feeling that there's an uptick in people who have just, you know, feel like they've hit the end. And so that's important to offer, some sort of remedy. Who knows, what one will find looking at the cards or whatever it is, talking to people. It's a very real situation, though.
Yeah, if they're having nightmares or something, implement black lights. The black lights you get at like party stores, because what black lights do, they neutralize the positive ions. So when somebody's having nightmares, they're having too many positive ions circulating in their environment. So neutralize them by sleeping with a black light over your head somewhere in the room. The black light's extremely important. Shine the black light into your mouth so you can neutralize the positive ions within your body. Black light. I have black lights all over the house. I have them in the shower. They cleanse your aura. I even take a solar charger with me to, like, if I'm at a cafe, I plug in the black light and I have a black light shining in my mouth at a coffee shop. I mean, I do all kinds of things that most people look at me and be like, this guy's insane. But I don't care because I don't have health insurance. I haven't got sick for 15 years. So it's like, you know, if it's working, don't fix it. It's not broke. And xenon bulbs, implement xenon in your life. Xenon is a noble gas.
What planet can one obtain some xenon from?
Well, anesthesiologists use xenon.
Okay.
And my mother was a nurse, and she always said the anesthesiologist is the most important person in an operating room. Because the anesthesiologist puts you in that deep sleep. And it's divine. It allows the divine intelligence within your body to heal you when you're in that deep sleep. So a lot of times people don't know this. Most people don't know this, but they'll create a scar, making it act like they did surgery. But the anesthesiologist put you in a deep sleep and allowed the divine intelligence to heal the issue that you were having in the body. They didn't do surgery on you. They just made it look like they did surgery on you. So
when I had a surgery on my knee, one of my knees, and I woke up from such a deep sleep. It was so shocking to wake up that I threw up. Maybe if I had gone into it with that knowledge of knowing where I was going and how to cope with it, I would have woke up in a different state.
Well, it's powerful because when I was at the barbershop when I was about 7 years old, and my dad asked where one of the barbers was, and they said he has pancreatic cancer. And I noticed the environment of the barbershop changed to a very depressive state. So I said in my head, I hope I never have that. Well, 35 years later, I was at the emergency room or whatever, wherever I was at the hospital, and I was breathing and I calmed down and I was no longer having any pain. And the doctor comes in and he goes, oh, I have good news and bad news. And he said, you have pancreatitis. And my whole body went into convulsion just based upon the word. And he goes, what's wrong? And I said, did you hear what you said? But he didn't know that happened to me when I was 7 years old. Wow. So the body always remembers, and the body never lies. It will never lie. It never lies to you. So if your body's telling you something, consider it a fact. And you have to support the body in the cleansing. What happens is the last stage of the healing process is when the issue surfaces. And what do? We start attacking the last stage of the healing process. Oh, you need to drink this tea. Oh, you need to take this drug. No, you just need to go to sleep and let divine intelligence finish the healing that it started 2 weeks before. But then they take these drugs, and now the body has to deal with what you just put in it. That in and of itself is a huge problem from a mentality standpoint. Because disease is the body attempting to be well. It's not. It's always attempting to be well. And it's just choosing that area to cleanse it, whether it's the lungs, whether it's the pancreas, the kidneys, whatever. That's where it's choosing to do its cleansing. So let it go about the business and, you know, sit under a black light, rest, drink a little water. What do cats do? Cats just get a little grass, lay in the sun, and then they, you know, they're good to go. But no, we got to do all kinds of crazy, insane things and call up our friends and go, what do I do? What do my migraine? You know, a lady had a migraine and she's like, I go, here's what you do. You go to Amazon.com. You get one of those frozen like caps that you wear on your head. You can freeze the cap and then wear them and the migraine will go away. Well, I took it to a different level because I know about heating and cooling, you know, supercharges the cells. So I said, sit under an infrared light until it gets hot enough and then put the cold cap on and then do that over and over and you'll supercharge the cells in your body and a migraine will go away. And she's like, and I just had put the freeze cap on a woman that was having a migraine at my house and that made it go away. It's not complicated. We're making this stuff way too complicated. And, you know, it's we've been confused for a long time.
Yeah,
we're still confused. I'm confused.
What's up, Gigi?
So, well, I got a question about the migraines, because when I get a migraine, it's not what, like, when other people say, like, oh, I have a migraine. To me, that's like, oh, ha, funny joke, because you don't know what a real migraine is. For me, here's what happens. It's about 45 minutes before my migraine kicks in, the vision in my left eye gets blurry. And that'll happen up for about 45 minutes until the migraine starts. Then once the migraine starts, listen, I've broken my wrist, I've broken my right arm, I've broken my elbow, I've had multiple concussions.
You landed on your nuts skateboarding.
Not to mention I've racked on my nuts straight on a handrail skateboarding many times. Yeah, good point, JP. but the pain that I feel when I get a migraine, what I call a migraine, is I would rather rack my nuts. I would rather break my arm. I would rather break my finger. I would rather break my wrist. That stuff hurts less than what I feel when I have a migraine. And it's weird because I have this, it's like a 45-minute notice. It's like as soon as my left eye stops seeing clearly and it gets all blurry, it's like, okay, oh no, I'm about to have a migraine. I have 45 minutes to prepare, so, you know, I'll take a bunch of sleeping medicine and try to knock myself out so that I can sleep through it. But what is that? Because that's not the closest word that relates to other people is a migraine. But when other people say, like, I've had friends call me on the phone like, oh, I'm having a migraine right now. I'm like, bitch, no, you're not. Because if what you're talking about is anything what I experience, you would not be talking on the phone right now. You know, like, I would rather snap my arm than have a migraine. Do you know what that is? What is that? What am I experiencing?
That's what usually people call migraines, because they're like, man, they will do absolutely anything. They describe basically very similar stories where it's be like, you can take my arm being broken and doing all these other things, but man, when I get a migraine, it's absolutely insane.
Okay, so
debilitating.
So I'm not alone. I'm not alone in that.
Oh no, the people that I here basically describe similar experiences. They say they've tried everything, and they may have tried 100 things, you know, and they'll try 100 more. So you know it's a migraine when the treatments that they've tried are pretty much above 25. usually most things, you know, you could get rid of by just, you know, resting, but a migraine, people will do about anything for that.
Any tips and suggestions on what to do? Or
we're
not doctors, but I'm just curious.
Well, we dock tas. I use the word ah. If you have a woman has tremendous healing properties. I would, I always head for the bath, a bathtub. First place, man, take a bath, soak in the tub. Number one, I've had kidney stones many times, and the first place I go is a bath. And that will get an enema bag. An enema bag should be your best friend.
I don't know, man. My recipe is, I guess my volume's going a bit high. I just take some.
That too.
I just take some go to sleep medicine, as it were, and sleep through it. You know what I mean?
Well, man, if that works, then you do it. You know, but hop in a bath and make the sleep even a little deeper.
Yeah, but then I might drown. So
just lower the water levels. The body will wake your ass up. The body never lies.
The body never
lies. It's always meant to survive. So if you're gonna drown your ass, it'll wake you up.
Right on.
And get the light. Probably the light frequencies disturb. We're under so much distorted light. Start having black lights. Put them in your house. Put them in your shower. Shine the black light at the computer so it neutralizes all the positive ions the positive ions coming from the computer. Or I even have black light shining at the Wi-Fi, you know, so it neutralizes all the ions coming out of there. It's a game of basically creating as many positive ions to destroy you. And they'll, you know, if you read the book, Melatonin, the Body's Wonder Drug, pretty much everything we use shuts down the melatonin. Vacuum cleaners, computers, I mean, they pretty much list everything we use to shut down the melanin that circulates within the body. So if you you can also, there's a diaphragm line that goes in between your thumb and your like the first finger, and then that line goes to the middle of the wrist. If you have somebody put two fingers on that line and put their thumb on the back side of your hand, and then put their finger in the medulla oblongata, the spot at the back of your neck, that will allow the energy to shoot up your spine, and then it will, the black door where you cross a fixation, where the crucifixion happens, that's the most melanated spot in the body. When that door opens, it allows the melanin to circulate through your body. It does tremendous healings. Tremendous. I had a woman that stopped at a store, or her husband went into the store, and she could not breathe. And she was like, had her head on the table. And I sometimes just show up at places. I don't know why I'm there. I'm just sit there. So she looks up at me and she's like looking at me, and I'm like, "You want to breathe?" And she's like, "I can't breathe." So I put my hand on her where the diaphragm line is, and I put my finger in her medulla oblongata. She was laughing within 2 minutes, and her husband came out like, he was like, "What did you do to my wife?" He left her where somebody should have called 911. And then literally within 2 minutes, she's like laughing, orgasmic, she's blissful. You know, that's how simple some of this stuff is. It's not like, you know, too complicated. So we are nearing
the end here. One question: what kind of black light, you mentioned black light earlier, there's I guess there's a few different ones, UVA, UVB, and UVC. I didn't know that.
Get the ones like, in the 70s at the party stores, like Spencer's and the mall have them. Those black lights.
Okay.
And, so do your own research, basically.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, look into it.
And plant growth lights are also, go to the, you'd be surprised at like a pet store. A pet store is a health store. They have infrared lights for the reptilian brain, quote unquote. And they have fish bubblers. They have plant growth lights because we were known as Septapana Man, which was man plant. So get one of these plant growth lights and also shine that in your mouth. The plant growth light is tremendously powerful also. So people will shine them on their plants, but they won't shine them on their body. So,
all right. Well, real quick. By the way, just to let first of all, Dragon Rose, who is one of our long listeners of this show and friend of the show and friends of our friend shows and everything else.
Are we kidding? She's bought us coffee, dude.
Yeah, not to mention she's the number one coffee buyer. So as you all probably know, if you don't, her and her partner Yorick Arnu, which we've also had the show, had on the show, they have been raided by the FBI for their research that they've been doing for God knows how many years, over at near Area 51, I should say. And they are actually going to be on Tucker Carlson on Wednesday to discuss the FBI raid, which
amazing.
Is absolutely awesome. So definitely make sure
millions
to tune
ahead
into that.
Are going to be
and,
millions ahead.
And Dragon Rose, just make sure to keep me updated with the links, and we will share that with our audience as well. And once time comes around, we will have both Yorg and Dragon Rose on the show, and we'll be discussing this as well in the near future. With that, thank you, the Nameless One, for coming on. I'm sure we can go on for another 2 hours, but unfortunately, our time has ended. Really quick, is there any links that you want to a website or where can they follow you?
Just you can contact me via text or Cosmic Card Consultants. It's KOSMIC and it's KARD and then consultants like Star Trek. KHANSULTANTS@gmail.com. And if you need something, I'll do my best to pass on information if I have it. And if I don't, I'll tell you I don't have it. But hopefully there's the information somewhere and I'll have access to it or lead you to who may have it.
So amazing to have you here.
All right, yeah, and thanks for...
I appreciate it, guys.
Yeah, thank you for coming on tonight, and thanks, JP. And but we have to go right this very now, ladies and gentlemen. This has been...
All right, stay well.
Shift Happens for The Fringe FM. The show is hosted and produced by yours truly. Co-host is JP. Associate producer is Brad Harris. And we have to go right now because coming up next right here on The Fringe FM is Light in the Void with Jaroop. All right, folks. We'll see you next week. Cheers to
you. Bye, everyone.
Stay well.